So if you're sitting while watching this, right, for every five breaths you take, probably about one is paying for your brain, another is paying for your liver, you know, another is paying for your muscles, and the other two are paying for all the other functions that are going on in your body. But even now, I'm spending a fair amount of calories just existing. I spend about 400, 450 calories a day just paying for my brain. My muscle, even if I'm not doing anything with my muscles constantly require energy. My gut is requiring energy. My kidneys require energy. My liver is requiring energy. My heart is requiring energy. So all of these processes are all adding up. Just existing is a fairly expensive prospect. And we have unusually expensive bodies, and a typical sort of human is spending about 1,300, 1,400, 1,500, 1,600 calories a day just on all those basic processes, even if they're doing nothing else. There are a lot of ways to quantify how physically active somebody is, right? A simple way of doing it is what's called the physical activity level. It's the total amount of energy you spend in a day divided by the energy you would spend just taking care of the most basic essential functions of your body. If you're in bed rest in a hospital and, you know, lying in bed with just like a clicker for the TV and you're doing absolutely nothing, not even digesting food, your physical activity level would be about a 1.2. And if you're like a Tour de France cyclist, it would be above 3. If you're kind of a desk worker, it would be like 1.6. So it's kind of a way to compare individuals, but also species, because it's standardized by your body size, because your body size essentially determines your basal metabolic rate. So your basal metabolic rate is a really important number because it tells you kind of just how much energy you're spending on just the essential maintenance of your body. And it turns out that a kind of typical, say, adult male my size spends about 2/3 of his or her metabolism just on basal metabolic rate. So I spend about 1,600 calories a day just existing. The fact that our bodies are so expensive helps explain why we tend to avoid unnecessary physical activity. Until recently, energy used to be limited. It wasn't like 7-Elevens or Dunkin' Donuts or Whole Foods or whatever your favorite place to get food is right around the corner. You know, if you wanted something to eat, you had to go find it. You had to either hunt it or gather it or dig it up. And energy was limited. And when energy is limited, you have to engage in trade-offs, right? We think so much about exercise in terms of elite athletics. You know, the fastest, the highest, jumping, the strongest, etc. And it's wonderful, right? It's great entertainment. But that's actually kind of what it is, right? It's actually entertainment. The world's fastest runners are able to do, or the world's best basketball players are able to do, have almost nothing to do with what most of us do, right? And so we get this kind of, I think, sometimes a perverted idea about what's normal from elite athletics, because we're looking at the extremes, the best of the best of the best of the best of the best. These are people who've spent years of their lives training to do just one thing and one thing really well. That's not what most of us do. For the vast majority of people, what they're trying to figure out is how to just get enough exercise. And I think the important message that often is missed is that if you're physically inactive and you're struggling to be more active, anything is better than nothing. You don't need to run marathons. You don't need to do a couch to 5K. You don't need to even do necessarily 150 minutes a week. Even an hour a week will be better than nothing. There's no one perfect dose. There's no one perfect type. And I think helping people understand that, I think, relieves them of some of the stress.
Get smarter, faster with videos from the world's biggest thinkers. And to learn even more from the world's biggest thinkers, get Big Think Plus for your business.